Hello, I'm Rodney from Rescued Art. Over the past 5 years, we have been on missions to save art from thrift stores that had been abandoned there. And I thought today I would share with you some of the secrets of picking valuable art at thrift stores that we've learned. One of the very first things I learned is that you need to have an affection for thrift stores. If you're just looking for art, then you're going to feel like you're trying to overcome the dirt and the mold and the sort of rough edge cultures that thrift stores present. So speaking of mold, you know that aroma that you get when you first enter into a thrift store? That's mold. And when mold is on a piece of art, it's called foxing. Now there's a very simple process, especially if you're dealing with a print that has a glossy or hard surface paper. There's a very simple process for removing that foxing. Now, if you want to take a look just up above me here, right in the view screen just above me, you see our website, www.rescuedart.net. If you put your cursor on there, you'll see the title of the article I'd like to send you. It's called Secrets of Picking Valuable Art at Thrift Stores. If you click on there, it'll take you to our website. And in the right-hand column, you send your email, and I'll send you a very detailed article. And one section of that article explains this process of getting foxing off of your prints. Now let's say that you are at a thrift store and you're looking at a piece of art. How do you know if it's valuable or not? One essential thing is you need to know, you need to determine whether it's a print or it's an original. Now, generally speaking, acrylics and oils are on canvas or canvas board, and they're exposed to the air. There's no glass over them. Whereas watercolors and prints, they are printed on paper, and so they will be presented with a glass over them to keep them protected from the environment. Now, it's sometimes a little bit difficult to determine whether you have an original or a print, especially in the area of watercolors. Now, here's a good example right here. This is a piece by John DiBartino. We found this piece just north of Fort Myers, down in Florida. And for a long time, this was on our site as a print. But some of the color was blocked because the frame was so small. So I took it apart, and I held the paper up to the light, and I saw that the paper was a little bit wrinkled, and there was a little bit of bleed through from the color, watercolor. That told me that this was, in fact, an original, not a print. And so I put some time and some effort into this piece. I put it into a larger frame, which I made out of oak. I also stained it. In that article, it also tells you how to create your own stains out of artist oils and commercial stain. And with this double mat and the larger frame, we now have a beautiful presentation of an original watercolor. And it also has about 5 times the value that it had when we thought it was a print. Now let me just note again, if you look up here in the view screen, you'll see where our website is up there. Just click on that, it'll take you to the website, and there is a tab there where you can give me your email, and I'll send you the article called Secrets of Picking Valuable Art at Thrift Stores. In there is another section of that article is a lot more discussion about how you differentiate an original from a print. So how do we go about determining the market value of the art we might find? In terms of prints now, the best prints are what's called limited edition and pencil signed. Now here's a good example here. This is a print by a fellow named Doug Helsell. We found this at a thrift store in Western Michigan. Doug Helsell is quite well known for his nature prints and his animal drawings. And you can see this is a pencil signed limited edition print. You see it's signed once, Doug Helsell, in the plate. That means before it was printed, he signed it. And then it's signed here again, Doug Helsell, after the print was made. So that's the pencil signing. So when you're looking for a pencil signed print, it's got to have 2 signatures, one in the plate, one after. And then it's got a number here, 238 over 300. That tells you that only 300 of these prints were made before they destroyed the plate. And this is number 238 of those 300. Just as a little point of interest, it's sometimes a little bit hard and get a little confused in this original or print world. And I just wanted to show you one example here. Some of the things I just told you a little earlier are actually not always true. Now take a look at this piece here. It's on canvas. There's no glass over the front. And it has brush stroking. It's an original oil, right? Well, no. This is actually a print. So, again, go to the article, www.rescuedart.net, click on that, get that article, and you can, I'll tell you the whole history of these prints on canvas with shellacking over the top, shellac brush strokes to make it look like an original. I should note that this is, you shouldn't consider this kind of work a fake. It actually has a lot of value unto itself. If you have a traditional environment where you want a European style piece of art hanging on the wall above the mantle or in a library, if you don't have a lot of money, this kind of work can serve you well. Beautiful piece of art doesn't cost a lot of money. Okay, so one more thing I just wanted to tell you. When you're going through thrift stores, always go through the store twice. The first time through, just get a general sense of what art they have to offer and a kind of a feel of the store. But the second time through, you start looking in corners, you start looking in under the shelves, under the big piles of art, and so forth. The art is almost always in the back. Now here's a good example of why that is true. This is a piece by Lionel Feininger. It was originally done, you can see here, in 1926. Feininger was a prominent member of the American Expressionist movement. This piece was by the back door, literally on its way to the dumpster. Even the thrift store had given up on this piece. All the frame joints were broken. The glass was coming loose. The backing paper was shredded. The hanging hardware was all rusted and so forth. And I almost gave up on it, but it was calling out to be saved, and I really enjoy bringing things, as I say, from the brink of the dumpster back to excellent condition. So I picked it up. It cost essentially nothing. I redid every joint in the frame and reinforced the joints. I refinished the frame. I added this second mat. So the time, it was quite an old print. It was at least 30 years old, this print, and light had made the mat a little bit dull, so I brightened it with a second mat and added a new backing paper and new hardware. Now look at it. It's beautiful. So let me just point one more time to the website at the top of the page. You click on that website, it'll take you to our opening page where you can get an article called Secrets of Picking Valuable Art at Thrift Stores. And in that article, there's a long section about all these simple repairs you can do to a piece of art to make it more valuable and to make it more beautiful. Okay, well, thank you for listening today. I hope you come to appreciate thrift stores the way that we do. And I hope you find some valuable art.